Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
My name is Alex Chaverin. I'm the training director at Five Star Dog Academy. The job of a great decoy is to progress the dog every single time you're in front of them, to push the limits and train through everything. It's from building a dog to challenging a dog and maintaining a certain amount of pressure from the beginning to the end. We're there to advance the dog every time we're in front in every training session. We're a sparring partner. I'm there to challenge you and push you as much as you push me and challenge you every step of the way. And at the overall day in our training session, it's for you to overcome insecurities and fight through everything I'm offering you. The job of the decoy definitely is an art and a science. You know, the art form is really knowing how to read the dog, manipulating and move with him, putting him right amount of pressure in order for him to overcome. And the science is you're working so many different types of dogs, from 130-pound dogs to 60-pound dogs, and they're flying at you as fast as possible. So the way you kind of come in there and absorb the hit, you know, with a certain amount of projectile that are coming in, comes into play, and you got seconds to really do that calculation and math, so you would be on top of your game. So when you're working with these dogs, you're really solving problems in geometry and biology both at the same time. As a decoy's job, we gotta go in there and push the limits and challenge them at the same time. We gotta work them safely. You know, so it's almost like dancing. We gotta make sure we're in the right motion, the right rhythmic movements. So I'm clearing his legs. When I'm coming in, you're doing stick hits, you're hitting them at the certain round of time and a certain part of their body where you're not causing physical harm. You're still putting enough pressure for them to understand that they still need to fight through these problems that we're giving them. And then we're offering different pictures at the same time. So challenge these guys and keeping them on their toes and thinking and make sure they're thinking mentally at the same time instead of just going off with just pure adrenaline or emotion. One of the most important parts as a decoy is catching the dog safely and learning how to absorb the impact, whether on the upper body or on the legs. Because, you know, one small step. These dogs are running at us 20 and 30 miles an hour full speed, and we gotta make sure we absorb all the impact with a certain amount of pressure so they can come in and make a good solid hit, not flying through us, but not jamming at the same time. So it's definitely gonna be a little bit of a dance motion that goes in between that. I attended a decoy camp this weekend, and the purpose was that to feed to my addictions, education and dogs, most definitely. It's always a good thing to go back and work your fundamental steps at the same time. Being around and growing around professional decoys is always a good thing.
Man, you cut me off back there. Yeah, you cut me off, bro.
So my experience with the camp was awesome. You know, pushing limits, testing myself, making sure I'm still catching dogs clean. I'm still in tune with all the new information that the sports and all these sport dogs are evolving in is gonna be very important for me. And just learning about myself and my conditioning, definitely. When you're out there working a certain amount of dogs, you wanna make sure you're up to par so your first catch looks just like your last catch with the same amount of pressure and consistency in your work. So the most interesting thing I did this weekend was the leg bites. It was a new challenge for me, something I don't have very much experience in, but the instructions and the amount of work that we got in made me feel very comfortable and learning how to cushion these hits, putting the right amount of pressure when I'm coming in at them, and then in the drives. You had to be very coordinated and be very athletic. I mean, you're using a lot of strength and muscles in those leg drives that you technically you don't get to use very often in everyday life. So my conditioning is something that's not up to par personally, and for someone that needs to be working around some of these dogs here. And I take for granted of kind of being a young guy and think I can go out there and wing certain things. But when you're in this suit and you're working 8 to 10 hours nonstop, that takes a toll on your body, most definitely. And it's a big eye opener for myself, and pushed me to new 2020 goals as far as my health wise, most definitely. So the camaraderie of all these decoys there was awesome. We're all professionals, we're all taking bites before. In the beginning, we kind of introduced ourselves, hey, how's it going, this round front, I've met you before, I've seen you work. And as the day starts going on, it just gets stronger and stronger, because we're all there for one mind and one focus, you know, and we all came to one, just cheering each other's on, and instead of really competing against each other, where a lot of times, I think, us trainers and decoys have to, you know, set a lot of high standards for ourselves. We just seen ourselves pushing ourselves to greatness. I'm definitely a better decoy now after attending this camp, able to grasp some good instructions from some valuable people out there in the community, and apply those small steps, even very minute things, is gonna advance me in so many great ways. The pressure that they put on you to overcome in your mental state of mind, it goes such a long way. You can always be in condition, you can always, you know, run a lot and do all that kind of stuff, but learning how to deal with pressure, and these dogs are flying at you with the intent. It's a whole different experience, definitely, that I highly recommend for anyone serious in becoming a professional decoy. So the future for me is looking awesome. I'm excited and looking forward to sharing a lot of the information I've received and passing it on to my club members and fellow trainers. This is just the beginning, as every decoy and trainer should be saying. I'm looking forward to participating a lot more in a lot of these camps. I'm going to go out there hunting for them. And this is something that just started a new fire under me, and it's been a trip how more motivated I am to go out there and work top quality dogs on a daily basis.